Hey guys, I wanted to do an actual review on the PB1000s. Now, I know if you've been watching the channel, you'll know that I've already covered these subs extremely well, but I didn't actually do a review of the subs themselves, so I wanted to do that today for you. A couple of things about these subs. Number one, the economics of these are really impressive. The fact that they got these small subs, and I say small relatively because if you look at the best subwoofer list, these are the smallest I've got on there so far, and I'm not expecting to be adding any smaller ported subwoofers. So, in terms of wife acceptance factor, these are probably the best. In terms of your spouse just not having a meltdown for having giant boxes in your living room, that's one of those issues that I do need to be considered. Because I mean, if you're happy with the sound, but your significant other is leering at you, it's all of a sudden not so enjoyable. So be sure to check, with your significant other and make sure that they're cool with it. But so these are the smallest, and the question I had with these are these things going to really produce in that sub 30 zone? You know what I mean? Because that's the hard part. Most any subwoofer can do great above 40. That's not hard stuff. The hard stuff is producing under 30 and with authority. You can have a lot of subs that have a rating of say 19 or 17 or whatever, but they fall off long before that. They like fall off at 30. Okay. These don't. These do not fall off at 30. I can guarantee that. I've put a microphone to it. I'll be putting up some test results on this page when I get it together and put it up. But you guys will be able to see these actually have extremely good performance under 30 hertz. It's very good. So in terms, if you're worried about that, I'm worried about them not going quite deep enough. Oh no, that's really not a big worry. If you've got a massive room, just huge. Sure, you might want to step up to something like the PB2000 or something else. But keep in mind, the reason these are here is because I did a review on two subs versus one. And believe me, two is a lot better, even considering a much larger single sub. So, and in terms of how these have done in my room is, basically 24 by 24. But I've kind of got it. I don't know. It's just kind of a weird setup. But these have handled it quite well. They're not underpowered at all. In fact, when I was initially doing my testing with these, I went way over 120 decibels in room, okay? It damaged my ears, and it took me about 2 to 3 weeks before I felt normal again. So if you're asking the question, will these be able to produce enough output? Yeah, unless you've got some, massive, massive room, you might want to go with something bigger, but in terms of how it did in my room, plenty. And throughout that entire thing, really cranking them and having them way too high, I still didn't hear any sort of misbehaviors or anything like that. They just don't falter. You know what I mean? And these, they have a frequency response in room where it goes down to about 21 hertz, and then it starts to taper a little bit, and then it gets down to 19, and it'll even go a little bit lower. And so, you can get under 19. It's not super strong, but you can get response, okay? What I'm after is where is the authoritative response? And in terms of authority, in terms of that punch that it hits you with, it's correct and doing what it's supposed to do, these go down to 21 hertz, and very, very comfortably. And under that, it's you still get output, but it's just not as much, But when you consider these specs against other speakers, when I'm talking about these roll off at about 21, you can have other speakers that are rated, or other subwoofers that are rated to 16 hertz, but their drop off starts at 35, okay? So what you get from 35 down to that supposed 17 hertz is, it's not there. I mean, it, there's noise, but it's not authority. You're not hearing it at the same volume as you would the rest of the content. So truly, when I say, you know, these start to roll off at 21, but they're rated for 19, that is a massive compliment. A lot of subwoofers out there, not the ones on my list, the ones I list are all very similar to this. They all have this proper performance. But a lot of other subs, like I said, they'll start to fall off around, you know, 35, 30, and it just the sound just disappears. Not true with these. These do a fantastic job. I'm really happy with them. I'm sending them back tomorrow. I'm not really super excited about that. I really like them. My wife loves them. They've been a joy. You know, they're not overpowering. You know, some subs that you set them up wrong or whatever, they just, I don't know. These are correct. They do what they're supposed to do, which is like the primary requirement of me listing anything on the website. So, you know, kudos to SVS for that. And I didn't mention it. SVS sent these out for me to listen to for the website and for this channel. So I appreciate them doing that. They've also sent out these drivers. And I mean, so that's a whole nother topic. But I've been, so far, I haven't heard a single SVS product I've been unhappy with. And that's just not just me. That's a pretty common theme throughout. You know, you ask anyone, they've been pretty happy with SVS. They're very, very good quality. But, you know, and a couple of things about SVS is that they have the Bill of Rights, which you don't pay for shipping. You know, when you order something, you order these subs, they send them out to you. You get a pair, they knock $50 off, it's $9.50, and they send it out to you, no shipping. Now, you have 45 days to listen. So in those 45 days, what you'll notice is that the subs will break in a little bit, and they'll actually play a little bit louder, so you have to turn them down a little bit as, I don't know, say about 2 weeks to a month goes by, and then you'll really get an idea. Within that 45 days, if you're like, you know what, these just aren't working for me, or you know what, I need to step up to the PB2000s or something like that, it's free shipping still. You know what I mean? So you sent it back and you just want a refund, you get a full refund. It's not like there's no restocking fees, there's no return shipping. It's essentially free for you to listen if you decide not to keep it. So they're making a pretty big bet in terms of shipping. These things aren't cheap to ship. And then beyond that, you've got a 1 year upgrade. So if you get these PB1000s and within, let's say, in 8 months, you're like, gosh, I really want something bigger. I want to step up to, you know, the, you know, say a cylinder sub, you know, a PC2000. You want to do that, you can. They actually give you full credit and for a trade-in. So let's say you got these for $9.50 and then you say, okay, I want to trade in at 9 months or, you know, 10 months, whatever. They'll actually give you $950 credit towards the new set of subs. The only thing they ask you for at that point is to pay for the shipping. And that is incredibly reasonable. That is beyond, I think they're the only one in the industry that does that. And I don't expect a lot of other people in the industry to do that. That's kind of an outrageous thing. But, you know, they've got such a good product, they can manage to do that. You know, it works out for them. And on top of all that, you know, they have full 5-year warranty on both the driver and the amplifier. So that is a pretty comprehensive warranty. So anyway, that's made me consider these to be the best subwoofers, you know, the smartest buy in bass. Okay. You know, and when I, to qualify that, what I mean is all the stuff that you get with it. You know, you get the ability to upgrade, you get the free shipping. There's no risk for you to try it out. You know, if you get it and you're like, this wasn't what I was looking for. You know what I mean? You're not stuck with it, or you're not paying hundreds of dollars in shipping. So, you know, for me, that makes it just, you know, kind of a no-brainer. And so, you know, overall, I've been real happy with these things. You know, I'm trying to think of anything that I've found that I've been unhappy with. And really, I mean, they're built really solid. They're you know, they're not small subs. I mean, they're the smallest on the list, but they're not tiny. They're not, you know, they're substantial. And the sound that comes out of them is beautiful. You know, they don't come in a piano finish, I think, at this point. That may change in the future. But, you know, one thing I can think of one issue that I did find with these subs was that one of the gain dials is a little bit stickier than the other. Like, it's a little bit harder to turn. And it's not like, it's nothing that affected any sort of performance. It was just, I wouldn't have even noticed it if I didn't have two of them to compare. So, you know, that's the worst I could find on these. You know, they do quite well. I think I don't know. I can't find anything wrong with them. So, you know, in terms of a reviewer, you know, that kind of doesn't say much about me, but really, they're fantastic. So if you guys are looking at these and you're thinking, you're wondering, are these going to be enough? Yeah, I had a massive 15-inch sub in here, and, you know, two definitely does the job a lot better than one. And, you know, what do you get when you step up in value and you step up in price, particularly in the SVS line? Well, you get more power, you get more, you know, driver, more comb area, and all that stuff makes the experience more convincing. Okay, so if you get more power and, you know, a little bit more depth and stuff like that, it just adds to the experience. So, you know, when you're looking at these, you know, should I get something bigger? That's for me, whether I'm going to get something more expensive than these, if I'm going to get something, you know, if I'm going to go to a PB2000 over these, for me, it's just purely a matter of economics. You know, if all I can afford is, you know, are these subs, I'm not going to cry about it. They're really good. But if I can afford the PB2000s, yeah, I'd pick those over these. But of course, I have a wife that doesn't mind the bigger subwoofers. So for me, it's not an issue. So, but if you guys are, you know, if that is an issue, these are worth considering. So anyway, guys, thanks a lot for watching. Hopefully this review helps. I've really enjoyed having these here. You know, I really expected to kind of not be super excited about them because of the size. I mean, it's just a 10-inch driver. But they have managed to pull out the power out of these, and it's amazing. So they've got the DSP in there, which EQs, you know, the frequency response so that the curve is nice and flat. And they do a good job. So anyway, guys, thanks for watching, and please subscribe.